Now I want to start working on giving some classes to these sidebar links, because we're in dark mode here and it looks kind of blah. So let's go ahead and fix that. If we go to the sidebar component, Inertia is actually pulling in Ziggy. That's part of this whole package that we have. And Ziggy has some really cool ways of adding classes to these. So let's do the first one. It's just going to be a conditional class. So it's basically looking for if the root dot current. Okay, so it's looking for this current root. This first one here is the dashboard link. So we'll be looking for admins dot star. Okay, the reason we're doing star is that this should be dashboard. Okay, basically, if we had, you take a look here, and let's say we had admins on different pages. So if we had admins show, admins, you know, edit, added, admins update, different pages within them, and basically this whole thing would be the color of the active link and any other link that we're actually in. So if we were in admins.update, then that both of those links would be highlighted as active classes. Okay, so that's just the rule of thumb when you're using the star. I usually will put it on everything, on all the links, just in case I decide to add any other links to the sidebar. That's one thing that we can do. So let's go ahead and now continue on with this. So if we're looking for admin dashboard, okay, we're going to say active. Okay, so if the current root that we are on is admin dashboard or anything under the dashboard set of links, then the class will be active. And if it's not, then we'll just return an empty string, or not an empty string, but no class, okay, other than the one that's up here. So let's go back, refresh, and we'll see if this link changes color. Okay, cool. So now that we are on the dashboard page, our active class is dashboard, and it's blue, which is much nicer than that other gray that was just sitting there. Okay, so let's go ahead and do the rest of them. So we'll just take this and copy it. Okay, and the next one will be tables. So I'm not going to do tables since it's just a drop-down menu, but we can go ahead and do it to the inertia link right in here. Okay, open that up. And then this new route will be admins. Okay, let's go down to the next one for the users and change this to users. We'll do the next for roles. And the next one here is permissions. Okay, so let's go ahead and refresh that and make sure that they're all working properly. Okay, so now if we go ahead and click tables, let's go to our admins page. Admins, users, cool, roles, cool, and permissions. Fantastic. So now all of our links are, we now have active links. The next thing I wanted to do was taking care of this dashboard page. Now, granted, this is just sort of a dummy page for the demo so that you could see how some basic things work. I want to go ahead and add our new members to this count up here. We can actually go ahead and add that. So if we go to our text editor and go to the admin dashboard controller, we can go ahead and display that using Carbon. Now, if you haven't read the Carbon documentation, I would really suggest taking a look because it's really useful and Laravel uses it for almost everything in displaying human readable time. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is create a variable and we're going to set it as Carbon. Make sure to import it now. Okay, so all this is doing is setting the variable for right now in this moment. Then we're going to set another variable called a go. and we are going to say now and subtract from now 3 days. What this ago is doing is looking for the current time now and going back 3 days. That's what we're looking for. Anything within those 3 days is what we consider new users. Hope that makes sense, but let's go ahead and pass in the props. Okay, so it's going to be users equals user. Go to bring that in. Where is admin equals zero? We are just looking for standard users. We are not looking for admins. Where date, and this is a Laravel helper function. Okay, that's all this is. We are going to be looking at the created at for those users, and we will be looking for whether or not it is less than ago. So any time between 3 days ago and right now in this moment, that's what we are considering as new members. And then from there, we just need the count without the E. Okay, so now we can go ahead and bring this prop into the page. We go to resources, JS, pages, admins, dashboard. And so now in here, we'll head all the way down to our script section. Okay, and then we are going to pass in those props. Users. Okay, comma. Close this. Now we need to find that section where that's being displayed, and it's somewhere near the top. Let's see, let's take a look at this. So likes, sales, new members. Likes, sales. So it should be right in here. New members. Okay, so now we can just use that variable for the prop. Users. Now let's go back to the browser and see what we're getting. Okay, so we have 50 new members. And they were made within the last... Actually, I know for a fact that these users were made more than 3 days ago. Okay, so let's head back into the controller. And now instead of is less than ago, we're going to do greater than ago. Okay, and then we should get a more accurate number. Come back, refresh it. Okay, and now we have one. In order to test that, we can actually go ahead and create a user. Users, create, see? And if you look at the date here, these were made on the 3rd, and today, as of me filming this, is the 8th. Okay, so let's go ahead and create one. Say, another new one. Another at test2.com. Create. Okay, and so now we have one and two, and so now on our dashboard we should also have two. Fantastic. Okay, so now the next thing I want to do is to go ahead into our tables, and this create button I want to make disabled if there's nothing in it. And how we do that? Well, I'm sure there are a few different ways to do it, but the easiest way that I found, we can close these, close that for now, and go to the user index page. Okay, let's head down to that edit button right here. Okay, and then we need to pass in some conditionals. We're going to say disabled equals if no form name or, that's what these two pipes are, means or if no form email or if the form is processing, and this is a new inertia processing. This is a new inertia thing for that they've done for the form, similar to the to the form reset and the form clear errors. It's along the same lines. Okay, so that should be good. Do I have any errors? No. Okay, let's go back. And now this button should be disabled. Okay, so click create. Okay, now it's disabled. We can't do anything. But if we say new user, new, and see, now it's no longer disabled. Okay, fantastic. So let's go ahead and do the next one. Edit should be the same. Well, edit doesn't really matter because there's always something in it. But if we were to get rid of this, then it would go to disabled. Okay. So the next one that we have like that is our roles table. Okay, so let's go back. Why don't we just copy this to save us some time? And then open up roles index. Okay, go up to this thing and put it at the end of this. But instead of all of these, we just need if form name and form processing. Okay, so let's go ahead and try that and see. Back, refresh. Okay, open up create, disabled button. Okay, fantastic. So now let's do the next one, which is permissions. Okay, so let's go to that page, index, head up to that edit function. Okay, and right at the end of here, we're just going to do paste, and I need to make a space there. So it'll be no form name, form description, and then form processing. Okay, go back and refresh. Go ahead and click create. And again, our disabled button. Okay, cool. Now the other thing I want to do is I want to turn on our admin layout preloader and fix that because I made a little mistake and I need to fix it so that you guys have a working preloader. Okay, so let's go ahead and turn it back on. Okay, if you notice up here, I have a class called preloader. Okay, but if you head down to the actual function, we'll turn this back on. I have loader here. Okay, so we need to go ahead and fix that. Now it's preloader, just like the class above. Let's go ahead and refresh and see if that's working correctly. Okay, and now it's doing what it's supposed to. Let's try to go to a different page. Go to the dashboard. Okay, but if you can see, it hangs a little bit. So let's try to go to another page. Let's see, admins. Okay, it works. It goes up, but you see it hangs out right there. So we need to fix some of the timings on here. Now, what I did to fix this was I just changed this one to 200, and that should make it do what it's supposed to. Okay, so let's go back, refresh. Okay, it went up. Let's try to go to a different page. There it is. Fantastic. Now it's gone all the way up. The next thing I want to do is to get rid of this sidebar here. Okay, so let's head back to our code. And if we scroll back up to the wrapper div up here, we just need to add another style. Style equals overflow auto. Okay, and that should make that, it should make this scroll bar disappear unless it's absolutely necessary. So we'll go ahead, we'll refresh it. Okay, and because it is a long page, it's going to be there. But if we go to one of our shorter pages, then it should be gone. Okay, fantastic. So for now, I'm just going to temporarily I'm just going to comment this out for now, just because we don't need it. It's really, it drives me a little crazy seeing it every time we refresh. So I'm just going to pause it for myself, but you guys can keep it active if you want. That's completely up to you. Well, the very last thing I want to do is, if we take a look at some of the tables that we have this drop down, and we have it set up so that you could see all of the everything that we have. So let's say a longer one would be permissions. Oh, I didn't refresh it yet, but that's okay. So if you take a look here, maybe not that one. We'll go to roles instead. Okay, and you open up create. And you see this drop down. So we have a lot of things listed in this multi-select. And we had to customize the style to get it to look like this. So what we ended up doing was, we can close this for now. We ended up having to put a style in the component. And I don't generally like to do that. So what I suggest instead is to get this out of here. So just exit out. And we're going to put this in one of our SAS folders. Okay. Now this already has a custom style sheet. So we can just go ahead and paste it in here. If you had a bunch more, then I would suggest creating a new kind of custom one and putting whatever it is you need to personally customize, put it in there. But at this point, since it's just the one, we can go ahead and just leave it here. Okay, so that was in the users table, so we can get rid of that. And, you know, it's about not repeating ourselves, and we want to try to keep from doing that as much as possible. And in things like these, we can definitely use this to do that. Okay, this one doesn't have one, but I think we have one in the admins page. Yep, we do. So let's go ahead and get rid of it there. We'll let that finish compiling, and then we'll go ahead and check. Refresh. Okay, so now let's take a look. Create. This shouldn't have changed at all. It should be the same. And it is. Great. Where's the other one? In our admins table. Okay, open that up. Same styling. Great. And see, that's admins. One more. Users. Okay, open up the create. Or no, it's in the edit. Open up the edit. And it's still the same. Fantastic. I think we managed to fix all of the known bugs that we had going on. And if you guys find anything else or have any questions about anything else, just drop a comment down below and we'll try to get it sorted out as quickly as we can. Okay, I'm going to leave it there. In the next episode, we are going to finally start using the Laravel Spatie permission package that we have and start cutting off some of these routes and links and just different functionalities we'll be cutting off from some of the admin roles. Okay, so I'm going to make sure to push all this stuff up to GitHub. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.